Welcome. Today we have Surya with us. Surya and I have been batchmates at IIM Indore. So thank you, Surya, for taking out the time and joining us. And I'm looking forward to have a very interesting conversation with you today.
Thanks, Ajay, for having me.
So Surya, I mean, in this interview, we'll try to know how your MBA days have been there, and then post MBA, how it has been there. So let's get it started with where have you done your schooling, and how did your undergrad college days go like?
Yeah, so I am from a small town near Visakhapatnam. I completed my schooling there. I've been to a missionary school all throughout my schooling, and schooling has been a good experience for me because it was not only about studies, but we had chance to explore different areas like extracurricular activities or sports. I have been mostly into sports. I was a I also played at state level. So it was a mix of both academic and extracurricular activities at school. So post which I in my 11th and 12th standard was mostly about academics, where I did not get chance to jump into sports back then. So after that, when I joined engineering, I did my engineering from GVP College in Visakhapatnam in Electronics and Communications. Engineering has been a different experience for me completely when I compare that with what I did in 11th or school, because 11th was more of an academic intensive activity, while engineering has opened different doors for me to explore what I have studied practically. And so that was the reason I used to spend most of my time at labs. Rather than reading more books, than I used to spend more time at labs, and also I came back to my habit of playing sports at college again. I did not get a chance to go to inter university level like the way I did at school, but it was mostly about spending every day at least an hour playing a sport. So that way it was a mixture of experience, both filled with both practicality and something that I always enjoy doing, which is sports. So that has been the journey until the end of my engineering. So post which I joined TCS, where I worked as a software engineer for nearly 2 years. I was working in Bangalore, and so in that experience, it was mostly about having a feel of what corporate is, how we deal with different teams and stakeholders, etc. Post the 2 years stint at TCS, I joined IIM Indore, where I completed my engineering, sorry, completed my MBA. And currently, as you know, I'm working in Cipla, where I'm working as a data analyst. So that's the journey so far.
So Surya, I mean, while you were doing your engineering, did you have thoughts about MBA, or when did this thought of doing an MBA start?
Yes, I had thoughts of doing an MBA. I think most of my classmates, when we were in third year of engineering, everyone used to think about doing an M.Tech or going for an M.S. in the U.S. So everyone started thinking about what to do next. That's when I also gave a thought about myself, what I really enjoy doing. So when I looked at what are the options I had, I basically picked two options. One was M.Tech, the other option being doing an MBA. But as I progressed for the next few months in college, I decided that MBA suits me better than going into M.Tech and becoming a more specialist technically. So that's the first attempt I gave. I gave in 2013, CAT 2013. That was my first attempt. So post which I again gave an attempt in 2015.
So you were given only, I mean, you did not write CAT 2014. CAT 2015 was your second attempt, and that's when you got into IIM Indore, right?
Right.
So Surya, when you gave your second CAT attempt, you were already working at TCS. So how was that like? I mean, how did you balance your preparation along with your job?
So the day I entered TCS, I decided that I would do MBA. But my thought process was different when I compared that with college, because then I decided that I'll have some experience on my paper and then go for an MBA. I felt that would add more value to something that I will do in MBA. So that was the thought process when I joined TCS. So I thought of completing 2 years. So the cycle was when I give CAT 2015, that completes the 2 year cycle or 2 year stint at TCS. And that's what I thought, just spending 2 years at a corporate and going back to MBA would be a better thing at that time.
So Surya, you've done your undergraduation in Gayatri Vidya Parishad. So how did that experience help you? How did that shape you? Because that's the first time we try to explore ourselves. That's the first stage or the first chance we get. So how was your experience at GVP and how did it help you in shaping up you as a person?
Yeah, as you rightly said, that was the first time I think many of us start exploring ourselves, because we were in that continuous race of getting marks and academics until 12th standard. So yeah, it was a fresh air during first year at college, although I was in the same mode of academics getting marks in the first year. But once, so the engineering was like, in the first year, it was more a generalist course where we will experience different engineering courses related to, for example, mechanical or electrical, civil, etc. But the most specialist subject they start from second year. So that's when we got a chance to explore what we really opted for. I got an opportunity to interact with good professors and even lab technicians who were really good at what they were doing. So that has pushed me into exploring more practically what I was learning than being so much worried about getting marks or academics. I think that was the first great experience I had, because that was the first time I started thinking anything apart from marks. So apart from that, engineering for most of us, as we also know, that it gives a lot of time. So we sometimes don't know what to do, or we sometimes spend figuring out what to do. So the same thing happened with me. I think some of the months I never know what to do. But in the next few months, I started figuring out what to do. I picked up few projects that I could do at college. Some of them I could do, some of them I could not complete. But altogether, that was a great experience, especially because when we are completely involved in academics, we don't get used to failures, because when we study for a lot of time, we mostly end up getting good marks, and that won't in many cases give us a sense of failure. But when we start something new, which is not known to us, at the same time, we have to interact with professors or lab technicians to understand. I think that's where I experienced failure most of the times. And that has pushed me into a different zone where I never had been. I think that was a moment those were the moments I cherish even now.
I think very well said, Surya. I think you were telling about the importance of trying, testing, and then failing and taking the learnings so that they'll be helpful for us in our further journey. So Surya, you got placed in TCS, one of the best IT companies in India. So what was the experience over there like? Because this is the first time a proper corporate experience someone gets, other than internships and all, which are only a small 1 or 2 month stints, which we have in engineering. So how did TCS, how did the 2 year period at TCS help you while you were in your MBA? What kind of experiences you had while you were working in TCS?
So when I joined TCS, my projects were mostly based out of, I did manual and automation testing in TCS, which was not as technical when compared to many people, what many people do at TCS. So I was initially just thinking if I'm doing the right thing, but when I started my project, it was more about stakeholder interactions, some business analytics and some solution. So I think that was something which helped me even in MBA, because as we move on, even after MBA, even in my current roles, the interaction with stakeholders, people management, getting along with the team, etc. The skills that that are playing an important role. So I'm glad that I got that opportunity back then. But otherwise, it was not very hectic. It was normal work at TCS. But I think the experience, the feel of corporate, and the experience of interacting with clients who are across the globe, that was something which helped me even. That is even helping me now in the current roles that I'm taking up here.
So Surya, I mean, whether it is CAT or whether we are working in a corporate, the role of mentors is very important. So did you have any mentors? What kind of mentors you had? What kind of role they played in helping you in your journey?
Yeah, I think particularly for CAT, I never had a mentor. I used to explore myself. I used to watch YouTube videos, or I used to read blogs and articles. I used to mostly know myself about what I'm getting into. So at that point, I did not know anyone who has come out of IIM so close that I can interact with them. So it was mostly my own journey. And I think the best mentors I had were, I interacted with a couple of faculty from Time Institute, where I took my GDPA. I think that was something which helped me later on. But completely from the sense of MBA and what happens after MBA, I did not have much idea back then.
So did that, definitely having less information beforehand would hamper some of the chances that we have, be it summers or other experiences at IIM. So looking back, did you feel that it would have been better if you had mentors, someone who has already been through the journey, to just have a slight sense of guidance? Or what's your take on that?
Yeah, I think it's definitely needed, because anytime the more informed we are, the better we will be able to decide. So I think most of us have chance now, because we are more interconnected now. So anyone who can get a chance to interact with someone who has already done their MBAs or who are doing their MBAs, I think that's a great idea to go with, because we will be well informed, and most of us, and some of us are from backgrounds where we don't have any idea of what happens in MBA. Because we are mostly constrained to engineering, and we don't know what happens after MBA. I think interacting and having a mentor would be a great idea.
Surya, a lot of people like you, after the graduation, if they're doing engineering, they join IT company. Maybe after 2-3 years, they try to get into MBA. But then while in MBA, we realize that I could have done a lot of things in during my stint at in an IT company, which would have been made me a better. So what would your advice be to your younger self who has been working, in a company like TCS or Infosys? What kind of things that they could have done which would help them be better off while they're in their MBA?
Is it during college or during while they were working?
While they're working in a company like TCS, let's say, like post their undergraduation, while they're working in an IT company, what kind of things that they could have done, maybe interacting with top leaders? Because after college, we are in an IT company, we feel that we are small because the company is so big, a lot of people are there. But then there are a lot of opportunities there as well. No one stops you from going and interacting with the leaders in the company, because that gives you the exposure, that gives you the understanding. So because you've been there in that phase from 2014 to 16, so what are the things that you felt you could have done back then which would have helped you in your MBA, be it interaction with the team leads or any other thing that you feel like which would be helpful to someone who is right now working in an IT company and who is thinking to go to do an MBA in the coming years?
Right. So I think, as you rightly said, it's more about interactions. The more chances we take to talk to people, I think the better perspectives we will have. And at the same time, we will also make better connections. I think even at the place where I worked, the top management was, they were welcoming interactions. They never shy away from interacting from the junior most person. I got the chance to interact with some of them, and they were always welcoming. Even with the idea that I want to go to an IIM, do an MBA, MBA was welcomed by them. Even they helped me in my exit of the company. So they were very welcoming in that case. I think anyone in that phase should take that chance of talking to people, not just in the company, but anyone outside the company, talk to them, get an interaction with them. I think all these things will definitely help as someone moves forward.
So Surya, I mean, you worked 2 years at TCS, and then in 2016, you started your journey at IIM Indore. So like we all know, term one is very challenging for everyone, be it a fresher or be it someone who is coming with an experience. So what kind of challenges you faced while in term one, especially during that crucial first 2-3 months just before the summers?
I think term one was very interesting, at the same time difficult for me, because I'm a person who has never been stressed as like we were done in term one. So that was difficult because you have to immediately stress yourself to long hours, doing a lot of things at the same time. But I think anyone, because we are a bunch of people who enter into a campus at the same time, and that environment gets created and we are pushed into it, I think it won't be so much difficult for someone to get along with others and get adjusted to the situation within a few weeks, if not days. So same happened with me. I was initially struggling and then got along with what was happening at campus. But it was a bit difficult in the first term to manage all the activities and academics at the same time preparation for summers. In fact, I could not do much preparation for summers because I was even in term one, I was struggling with time management. So which I could rectify as I went along into term two and term three. But term one was challenging. At the same time, it was a great learning in term one.
So Surya, for summers, were you clear or confident that I want to go towards finance or marketing? Like, what was going through your mind? Like, it would be better if I get into this kind of a company. Were you having thoughts like that? Or were you just, taking one thing at a time during the initial phase of your MBA?
Yeah, to be open, I think I was exploring because in term one, for the first time in my life, I've seen marketing, I've seen finance and operations I know a bit, but most of the other things I've seen for the first time in my life. So I was confused about what to do. So I had no idea. I thought if I got a good finance company, I'll be happy. Or if I get a good marketing internship, I'll be happy. But at the end of the day, it was one interview after the other. And I finally got into finance role in L&D. So it was a mixture of that. I was not very clear about what I wanted to do.
So then after term one, after the summers are done, slightly things start slowing down. I mean, basically things don't slow down. We get adjusted to the pace, but then summers and other things, since they're not there, we can try to focus more on the acads and then on the learning part. So how was your term two like? Because term two, I mean, gradually our understanding of what an MBA really is starts coming through. So how was term two like for you? Because the number of subjects also are more compared to term one. And we also get to have some more clarity as we enter term two. So how was it like for you post the summers and the hectic phase of the first 2-3 months?
I think term two was a term of clarity for me because I was very confused in term one. But when I entered into term two, we did not have this bag of summers or most other things that we used to do in term one. So I personally got a time to understand what I'm doing. So to understand more about marketing or finance or HR. And term two, in term two itself, I got a fair idea of what I'm going to do at MBA. It was finance for me. I loved doing finance, and it gave me a fair idea of what I'll be doing in the next 1.5 year at college. And although I did not have much thought about what really happens in corporates, but that was something that excited me in term two. That's all.
So Surya, I think more or less the same thing would be there for term three as well. And since we don't have, I think only except for a couple of electives, the rest all would be the same for everyone. So, did you, did you look forward to summers? Were there, were you having a buddy or someone who was guiding you before the summers actually started from L&T, or how was it like just before joining L&T? How was the communication from the company like?
I think from the company side, we did not have communication. We did not have a buddy or mentor. But once we joined the company, we had a mentor and a buddy as well. But before joining the company for internship, we had some seniors who interned with L&T in the previous years. So I interacted with them, got to understand how the internship looked like, etc.
So Surya, summers, though it is only just a 2 months experience, this is the first time post, half of your MBA, you're through half of your MBA, and then you're having this chance right now. You have a lot of knowledge that you have acquired in the past 8, 9 months. So what was your process like while you're entering summers? Were you thinking like, okay, right now I'll do these two things in my summers apart from my projects? What was going through your mind? What were you trying to achieve through the 2 months stint apart from delivering the project deliverables that have to be done from your end? What was going through you during that phase in 2017?
So when I entered the company, so even before joining for internship, my thought was I get a project and I'll get to work on the project. But when I joined the company, it did not work like that because the problem statement that they have given me was it has a wider scope. And when I went into the realities, I could not find many areas where I can improve. And at the same time, another problem was I used to get quite a less time from my mentor, so that added to the problems. So my take back then was instead of working completely on what they have given, where I could not see many improvements, I'll expand the problem statement a bit and find out an area where I can add value. So that's what I have done. Well, the problem statement that was given to me was to improve the liquidity system there. I expanded a bit. So it was basically improving a system which is already there in the company. So I expanded that to their projects in other countries where this system was not there. And as per the legalities, regulations, and the currency transfers, etc., at those countries, I came up with a different problem statement. And at the same time, it's a project that is somewhat linked to the problem statement that was given to me. So I think in that way, I was able to convince them that this is something which will work rather than just the problem statement that was given to me. I think that the process of exploration and the confusion that I had initially, all that was a great journey for those 2 months.
Also, Surya, we get to interact with a lot of other B-school candidates who come to do their internship as well. So, did you have the opportunity? Were there other interns from other B-schools who were working along with you as interns during that time? What was that interactions like?
Yeah, so I interned with people from IFT and IIM Kozhikode, and some of them are from my college itself. So the interactions were really great. The people from different backgrounds brings on table different ideas. At the same time, I also got a chance to share my flat with these two people who are from, sorry, three people who are from IIM Rohtak, IFT, and IIM Kozhikode. So the interactions were always great, not just at office, but even at the flat, we used to interact and share ideas, not just about office or academics, but beyond that, about books, about what everyone likes, about sports, etc. So a lot of interaction happened in those 2 months, because not just because of the time we spent at office, but also because we were living together. So that was a great time.
So at the end of summer internship, what was your experience like? Were you liking the experience that you had, the 2 months experience that you had at L&T? Were you, I mean, did you have enough clarity what you wanted to go for in your final placements, be it finance or analytics or any other area that you, did you get clarity after 2 months of internship?
Yeah, I think the first thoughts were I like finance, but at the same time, I like anything which is analytical. It's not just finance, it could be even operations. So that helped me take subjects. So in second year, although most of my subjects were in finance, I took subjects in operations, analytics. I explored different areas in second year. I think in that way, the internship gave me a wider thought process than just only about finance at the time.
So Surya, I mean, year one and year two MBA are like two different phases. And also when you come into year two, you come with the experience of year one plus summers. And as a result, your year two, the perspective would be completely different. So how was it for you? I mean, you already spoke about how the summers and the other experiences helped you in taking the electives and all. So how was it for you? How was year two different from year one MBA?
So year two, in my view, is more about doing the things that we like, because there was no pressure for you to do certain things because they are the part of academics or they are the part of activities that you have to do at college. So second year is more about freedom to choose what you want to do. And I think same happened with most of us. In my case, I decided to focus more on things which I don't understand, especially in academics. So I started taking courses in finance and analytics and operations. Most of them are completely new to me. And that's how I wanted to spend my time as well, to understand things which I never knew.
And also, Surya, I mean, very well pointed. Like it's not a situation where we are pressurized to do certain things. And also, the electives that we take are through our own choice. And so we get a chance to work on interesting projects. So, what are some of the interesting projects that you still remember from the electives that you have taken in second year, which you felt were interesting and which you really put your effort and worked into?
Yeah, I think one project was in a course called Data Analytics and Learning. That course was a bit different because that was the first time we tried to understand the data science, machine learning, all these new areas which we haven't touched. Even they were things which are not taught in normal MBAs. So that was a new experience for me because they are things that I haven't touched before. And we spent some time to understand them, work out on the project and get some result out of the project. So that was one project I remember. The other project was in an elective called Project Finance, Project Appraisal and Financing. So that was, we studied a project, an airport project in Cochin. And the amount of study we have done, I think, it was vast and it helped me even in later phases, what I have done in that project. So I think these two projects are something that I remember and which I can relate to even now because of the things I'm doing here right now.
So Surya, I mean, even before, time passes very fastly and then the final placements come very soon. So how did you prepare for the final placements? Were you aiming for lateral placements? What was your preparation like during that time?
Yeah, so definitely I was waiting. I was looking for lateral placements because I had some 20 months of experience back then and I was getting decent shortlists and lateral placements. So I wanted to convert lateral placements, especially in some consulting firm. I have gone through interviews in consulting firms, but I could not convert any. So after the consulting firms were over, I thought I should focus more on going to the main interviews. I was not much interested in the companies which are coming after these consulting firms in the lateral interview phase. So I started preparing for main interviews, and I could convert Cipla on the first day.
So Surya, I mean, when we are preparing for the final placements, unlike summer placements is the sometimes at the back of our mind, it will be there like, okay, it's fine, it's 2 months, it's okay to miss opportunities. But then, even though we are more settled in second year, final placements really take a toll on you because that's the first job you're getting post your MBA. And like you rightly mentioned, you missed your chances in lateral placements, and this happens with a lot of people sometimes because the companies might take less numbers or a lot of other factors which are completely out of a candidate's control. I mean, other than preparing ourselves for the interviews. So how was that phase like? Because it's going to be a very difficult phase because there is this always there in the back of your mind that you could have done this thing well in the interview, or you could have maybe prepared well, or this thing did not go well, that's the reason I did not get selected. So all these things will be going on. But then if we keep these things in our mind, the next good opportunity will not be able to perform better. As a result, we will lose the next best opportunity or even an equally better opportunity. So how are you coming out of those things so that your next interview is not getting affected? How are you managing your mind during that time?
So I think these are things that we have already experienced during summers, because that was the first time we see series of failures and we have to deal with each failure and get doing well with the next interview. So that was the first experience summers. I think the lessons that we have to draw are from summers, even before we entering the laterals. But every interview during laterals also this applies, because when we see the series of failures, we have to keep our energy high. Especially because even the days are long, we have to wait for a long time before interviews. So we have to keep your energy high, firstly. And secondly, the learnings from summers and all the interviews that we had already taken during lateral, that is something that we have to keep in mind and just keep things easily going. Even that's what I have done. I mostly tried not to be stressed out because of things which were not working out. But as I went on with the next set of interviews, I used to be always optimistic and especially energetic.
I think, yeah, Surya rightly said about those things. And also, I think, Surya, the support that we receive from our batchmates who are already placed, that also actually helps, because I remember a lot of people try to help us with the pre-processes or preparing about the company, the industry and all. So all those things together, maybe we can be better prepared for the next opportunity that we are going to get in the campus. So the placements are done, and then just we have a term 6, which will be just 2-3 months, and then after that we'll be in the corporate. So your MBA is done, and then you started your journey at Cipla. So how was the journey for the last 2 years has been like at Cipla? Because I think you just completed 2 years at Cipla. So how has the journey been so far?
I think most part of the journey at Cipla was exciting for me. I joined as a data analyst in Cipla. And in the initial few months, most of my time was dedicated for learning. My team, the company, they have given me an opportunity to learn because I was dealing with advanced analytics as well, which is not something we do generally as a part of MBA. So apart from the normal analysis we do on data, the other thing which I was doing, which is advanced analytics, had a lot of learning to be done. So it was very exciting in the first year, because I was parallelly implementing projects. I was at the same time learning different things. And at the same time, second year was mostly about implementation, getting projects done, more of stakeholder management, etc. So it's been a great journey so far in Cipla.
Surya, a lot of people who are right now in the second year MBA would be looking to have careers like you get into analytics. So someone who is going to graduate in 2021, right now they would be starting their second year journey. So what would your advice be, what they can do to align themselves? Because a theoretical perspective is different from a practical perspective, and you had chance for the last 2 years to see that side of the business. So what your advice would be to someone who is thinking to start making a career in analytics post his or her MBA?
Yeah, I think the number of roles which are offered in analytics are increasing, and there will be a fair amount of roles. So I think from a placement point of view, if someone wants to get a role in analytics, it won't be so much difficult. But in order to do some background for entering into analytics, where especially the work is related to advanced analytics, I think some background work needs to be done in college or even in the free time that we get even before joining the company. So with that orientation, I think someone will be in a good position to start their journey in analytics. At the same time, someone who spends some time in analytics may or may not feel that going forward he or she might want to do something different. So that always happens in our minds. So I think we should be open. If you are interested in analytics, just go for it. Learn and enjoy the process. At the same time, be open if you want to do something else.
So Surya, because of the pandemic, how has the opportunities, according to you, how has the analytics field has been? I think you'll be in a better position to answer that rather than others being at Cipla and seeing how the things are going. So how is analytics going to be there maybe 6 months or 1 year down the line?
I think there won't be much impact in the next 6 or 10 months, especially for analytics, because the impact is mostly based on industries. If we look at pharma, there has been an impact, but not much when compared to other industries. So similarly, the dynamics inside industry play a more important role than particularly looking at a function like analytics. So that's what I feel.
Surya, I already know that you're very much interested in trekking. So how did this interest of trekking start? Because a lot of times when we discussed, you told how that brings in a balance, because we work on corporate on one side, but then on the other side, things like these help you relax and help you get a better perspective on life. So how did this trekking thing start, and take us through your experiences so far, because you've been onto other treks as well.
Yeah, so for me, trekking is like, for most people, for different people, it's different things. For some of us, it's painting. For some of us, it is some sport or cycling or singing, a lot of things. For me, it's trekking. So I got an opportunity to, I did a lot of treks even in engineering, especially near Vizag, where we have some mountains. But I think the life-changing event was when I did my first trek in the Himalayas. So it was completely a different experience. And so when you are so happy about something, you feel that, right? So I got that feeling when I did my first trek in the Himalayas. And then I decided this is not something I'm going to stop. And so that's how it has been going since then. I try to do at least 2 treks in a year. If ever I get time, I try to roam around and do trekking. Even I live in Mumbai currently, so where I have enough chances to do a lot of treks in Mumbai as well. So it's just like many people painting or singing at the end of the week after a long week of work. It is just as simple as that for me. But at the same time, the other advantage I gain out of it is being fit, physically fit. So I think it's a advantage of two types, which is just both kept me mentally and physically well.
I think, yeah, I mean, when we are planning for a trek, this thing that, okay, I have to be fit will be there in the back of our mind, and we start training at least 2 months or 1 month prior. Yes. And as a result, you're going to be fit. I still remember during our second year when we had Himalayan Outbound program, everyone in the campus was trying to get fit. So that was really helpful, I think, during the final placements, because all of us came back fit to the campus post the HOP. So yeah, that even after getting into corporate, we should keep ourselves active, because it's going to be a long career, and then there are going to be a lot of ups and downs. So yes. Suri, apart from trekking, what are the other hobbies? I know that you do read a lot of books. So how did reading help you through your journey?
I think someone has rightly said, reading is something that will impart you a lot of knowledge because of years of effort kept by that writer. So that's a very important thing I believe in. At the same time, I respect the writers, because it's a lot of research that they do, especially when I'm talking about non-fiction books. So they do put in a lot of effort, years of effort, to bring that research and write a book. So when we read that book in 1 week or two, so the learning we will get out of so many years of research done by that writer, I think that's unparalleled. So even when we don't get too much time to read books, I believe that we should spend whatever time we get in reading a book. So it has been a great learning process through books, because we are mostly now involved in doing work all throughout a week, and in most cases, some of us might be doing redundant work as well. So that hunger to learn something new always will be there in us. So I think books fulfill that hunger for me, at least. So I want to keep that habit going.
Okay. So Surya, especially a lot of us, we have this hindsight bias. So for example, when we were in PGP 2, when PGP 1s come and ask us advice, we kind of say that it's okay, you'll go through it. But then it kind of becomes easy because we have been through that. But then when you are actually in the moment, it's kind of very difficult because you are giving interviews or you are going through your term on hectic schedules and all. So sometimes advice it's easy to give advice when you're past that and done that. So Surya, with this perspective, I want your thoughts on someone who is right now joining their MBA, who is in their MBA first year, who has just started their journey. And unfortunately, because of the pandemic, a lot of initial part of their journey is going to be online. So this adds more to the challenge. So thinking all these things, what would your advice be or what would your thoughts be to someone who is just starting their MBA journey, keeping all these things in mind? So what would your advice be specifically to MBA first years?
So for MBA's first year, I think it's completely a different experience now, as we all know. But the primary thing in my view is to be open. Open to things that come up, because there is no fixed way that that they will get things like the way we experienced our other batches who were physically at college experience. So it would be more about being open to things that come up in different channels for them, and embrace that challenge. So I think if they are trying to do that and they're successful in doing that right now, even at a later phase when they can enter the college, they'll feel it much better and much easier to cope along with whatever challenges they will get. So just be open and explore. I think that's what I will say.
Suri, coming to batch of 2021, who are just going to pass in the next year, we have seen the issues or the problems that the batch of 2020 has faced. They did not have their graduation ceremonies. A lot of companies were rolling back the offers. But also the other challenge that is coming up is the batch of 2021 might face an even bigger challenge given how the situation is. So, but one good thing is they still have 7-8 months at hand. Unfortunately, they are going through the process online. They might be missing a major part of their second year being in campus. These challenges are there, but then new opportunities might come up. Maybe not immediately while they're passing out, but then the kind of shift that the world is going through. So from the industry perspective and also having the experience post-MBA of almost 2 years, for someone who is going to enter this difficult phase in 2021, graduating, maybe a lot of people might not be even able to get placed because of the situation, because of how the industry has been there and all. So what would be your thoughts would be regarding them? How would you think that they might be better off in the next, what they should be doing so that by the time they're passing, they might be in a better situation?
Yeah, I think primarily the first thing is they should concentrate on what they have in hand in second year. Concentrate on what they have already decided to do. For example, if someone has decided that I want to enter into finance or marketing, the primary thing I think in my view is to be good at it. Although the opportunities in terms of physical interaction with a lot of people, like we usually do at college, doesn't happen at this point of time. I think people in second year should try their best to do that. And secondly, I think although there might be challenges in terms of placements, I think once the market revives, the college brand that they are already in is something that will definitely help them to be in the front run for any openings that are going to open once the economy goes into that positive path. So yes, there will be a bit of worry about what's going to happen. But I think these two things is something that I feel that might help them in the next 1.5 years once they get graduated.
And also I think looking from the opportunity perspective of this particular situation, someone who is graduating in 2021 and is having this 7, 8 or 9 months period in between might be able to think new models, might be able to even think or design projects of how the things have to, things are going to be there, and then maybe modify their own preparation accordingly, because all these companies right now would be requiring talent to get out of the slump, and the number of skills that that a candidate possesses will be definitely helpful. So the more skills that a candidate acquires during this next 8-9 months period would definitely be of help. So Surya, also let's share our thoughts of for someone who is in their engineering, because especially during that 4 years of undergraduation, when you're in engineering, you get a lot of time, and that's it. That's an age when we can actually afford to fail, because you have both time on your side and you have nothing to lose. You just fail, you learn from it. So what do you think? Because when we did our engineering, and right now someone who is in their third year, who is going to graduate in 2021 or 2022, the kind of opportunities, that the kind of technology or the kind of internet penetration that we have is very good, because back in our days we did not have affordable internet connectivity. But right now, if you want to just connect over social media with anyone and just to get an advice, be it mentorship like we already discussed, be it mentorship, be it trying out on projects or working working with people across the locations, so all these new opportunities are there. But based on my interaction with the undergrad students, I felt that a lot of people are not exploiting these opportunities, not a lot of people are learning. So what would your advice to be someone who is in their second, who is in their undergraduation, basically, what kind of things that they could do so that they'll be better off, be trying new things or any other thing that you wish to share with them?
Yeah, so I think undergraduates now have, not just undergraduates, even for people who are in schools, even in 11th and 12th standard, have more opportunities because of internet penetrations, like you are saying. Even back in college, when I was doing engineering between 2010 and 14, I could get broadband connectivity only at the library of college. So it was so difficult, because only 2G was something that was very handy at in our mobile phones. So now it has completely changed. That's the first thing. I think the opportunities are in their hand or in their mobile phones because of good internet connectivity. So the second thing, if I were in engineering now, what I would have done is I would have interacted more with people. I would have been more active at college. So I was someone who was not very active in engineering, although in some parts of engineering I was active when it comes to extracurricular activities. But I was mostly spending, I was studious, or I was trying out new projects, etc. So I think that's one thing I would have done differently. The second thing is aiming big or doing something big. So like I said, I have done a few projects in engineering, but they were not so, the goal was not big. They were not audacious goals. So there is more probability that I will win, that I will complete the project, than I would end up not completing the project. I think that's a wrong signal to start a project. So if I were an engineer now, and I would have taken up a project which is not as easy as something that I have done back then, I would have taken up something which is far, far difficult, and prefer to fail, because even with failing in that project, I would have learned a lot in that process, because the goal itself was so big that I had to learn a lot.
So I think, Surya, I think very well pointed about rather it's better to be trying and failing at big things rather than aiming small and getting successful at them, because the learning would be very less. And also, I think, Surya, right now, because of the work, I mean, majority of the digital economy or majority of the knowledge work being done remotely, I think the opportunities are also democratized. Maybe previously the companies might just visit colleges, top colleges, and then recruit talent. But right now they have even the companies would be looking to recruit the best talent, because even some part of best talent might be sitting colleges outside of NITs or IITs when we are talking about engineering, because that's what we are from. So if the people are actually ready with the right skill sets, and if they're actually having the right mindset, and like you discussed just now, if they're able to exploit the opportunities, learn, and then do difficult projects, I think they'll be giving them an equal chance to be placed in better companies. So that's a very good point, Surya. So Surya, let's go back to your MBA days once again. What would your advice be to overall to your younger self who is being there in MBA, a few things that you felt that you could have done better, be it in your first year or second year?
Yeah, I think I was one of those confused persons at college, not very clear about what I wanted to do when I entered the college. I think it happens with some of us. Some of us are, while entering the college, they were clear. They had CFA once, they wanted to do finance, or someone wanted to do marketing. Some of us were very clear. Well, there are also others like me who are not clear. I think the first advice is just be open when we are not clear. Let the course unfold and choose what you wanted to do. That's one advice. And secondly, I think we will be involved in a lot of activities that's bound to happen. But the second advice will definitely be spending more time and understanding the area of interest. I think in the college, I there are two things that I explored. One, I'm interested in economics, which I follow even today. And second thing, I'm interested in physical fitness. I think these are two takeaways out of the college. So not just from the point of view of placements or academics. I think there are different areas where we can explore. So I think being open will be a right thing to do at college.
Thank you, Surya. I think you shared a lot of good insights, and I really enjoyed our conversation. And I'm looking forward to have a few more conversations with you in the coming years and decades, Surya.
Thank you so much, Ajay. For sure, I'll do it.